This one, chop one and chop two.
Leave the tea now.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're watching my videos for the first time, my name is Prudence Apinoko and this is...
I'm Mr. K Apinoko.
And we are the...
Apinokos.
And on this channel, we talk about faith, lifestyle, we do vlogs, we do cooking videos, marriage, we do fun stuff. Only good stuff here. So guys, welcome. And if you're watching this video and you are not a subscribed member,
subscribe already,
please subscribe, hit the notification bell so whenever we post videos, you'll be the first to see it. So yeah. I guess you guys saw already from the title, we have a platter of goodness in front of us.
I can't wait to start digging in, especially this one in my front. This one is
for disco.
Yeah.
So guys, without further ado, let's get into the
video.
Guys, this is a snacks mukbang. Have you seen? Is it mukbang? But it's a mukbang. You know how they say something mukbang. So our own is story time mukbang. So chat with my husband while you watch me eat the snack. So why are we here today?
So today, you know, a few days ago, my wife shared her own story of how she almost married a 40-year-old man. And today I want to share my own story, because down in the comment section I said something about how both of us came from heartbreak and got married within six months or thereabouts. So I'm going to give you the full gist of my own experience, my own story. You know, this is a story that my wife has not.
Unfortunately, forgive me, I'm busy.
My wife don't even have the fat, so this is the first time I'm actually.
All of us are in this together for the first time.
So, back then when I was in school, I had a girlfriend and we were very close. You know that kind of relationship that the whole campus and the whole community, they are aware that, okay, these two people, they are in a relationship, and because of that, nobody goes against, you know, that kind of relationship. And I was very popular in school.
I studied at
Delta State University, Ole Campus. I've been in this relationship before I graduated from Ole Campus in 2013. And we've been in the relationship for 2 years or 3 years or thereabouts before I graduated. And when I was in law school, we were very much in communication. We were talking on a regular basis, I think daily also. Then on this particular day, I got a message from one of my friends. He said he was just asking me questions. I said, I'm okay, I'm good, I'm doing good. That is lost because I said, thank God. Say, how is your girlfriend? I said, my girlfriend is fine. We just spoke some few minutes back. He said, are you serious? I said, yeah. Say, what's going on? He said that what he's saying is something that he cannot even voice out, that I should go and find out myself. I should pick a phone and log into Facebook and go and look for myself, that it will not be the one that will cause me high blood pressure, or will be the one that will break news that will lead to something bad, that I should go and find out for myself. So I logged into Facebook, and what I saw was, guys, it was terrible. A girl that I was dating, that I thought I was dating, is engaged to someone. And the whole thing, it was so funny because this girl never told me about anything. So me finding out on my own, I reacted in a very funny way. But after,
how did you react?
I was heartbroken. I was shattered. It took the grace of God as those people that were around me to really help me get through the whole drama. Like when I called her, she said that it was an accidental engagement.
Is there something? Is there anything like that? Accidental engagement.
If you ask me, I'll call her son. Well, she said the guy is a pastor and that she escorted the pastor to see a bishop. And when they were there, the guy proposed to her. Mm. And because she wouldn't want to reject the proposal in the presence of the bishop, she accepted it, and that was how the whole drama happened.
Wow.
Then I said, okay, why didn't you tell me? She said she was looking for ways to tell me.
But hold on, don't you think she had been dating the guy since? I feel like, because men, I don't know if I'm not speaking you guys' mind, I don't know how something you can be. You must have been in a relationship. You will know the person, you will know. Okay, like when the both of us met, my cousin introduced us. But then we already knew that. So when ring was coming, it was not a surprising thing because I already knew that this one is marriage something. Do you get? So I feel like, I don't know guys, what you guys think? I feel like she was aware. Maybe she was double dating.
I feel just so too.
Say it in the comment section if what I'm saying is right. I feel like she was double dating and then she didn't know how to tell you, yes, but it wasn't something that she wasn't unaware of. She must have no, somebody cannot just come and just engage you like that.
So that was the storyline she brought, and I said, okay, fine. Okay, the thing happened that way, why didn't you tell me? To the extent that someone is calling me to go and check Facebook, and you even posted the pictures on your Facebook profile. She said actually that she's thinking of changing her mind. She no longer wants to go ahead with the guy. That she wants me to come and pay her bride price. She wants me to marry her, blah blah blah. I said, okay. I wasn't there when you accepted the proposal.
Yeah.
That you should go and sort yourself out. If you are able to sort yourself out, fine and okay. But mm-hmm. if you can't, go ahead. I don't have a problem. So we're still talking. My dad got to know, because she's that kind of girl that I brought to my family. They welcomed her. She even when I was in law school.
Mm.
She can go to my house and they'll give her provision, give her anything she wants.
Mm.
And so the relationship was there. So my dad found out and he was telling me that, okay, I should just let everything go like that. So
daddy.
But something within that period, I went to Asaba to do my court and chamber attachment.
Mm.
So when I was in Asaba, she called that, okay, she wants us to meet. Initially, I was reluctant, I didn't want to meet her. Then my dad said, okay, I should just go and hear her out. Let me hear what she has to say. So I met with her, and she said she wants to call up the engagement and suspend all the wedding plans and arrangements.
Wait, how old was this girl?
At that time, she was 23 or 24.
Okay.
That if I agree that you should stop the whole wedding arrangement.
How old were you?
I was 28. Okay, that if I agree that I will come and pay her bride price, she will put a stop to the whole wedding arrangement, that I should come with my family just to pay the bride price, and after law school, I can do the marriage. So I said, go and do your part. The ball is in your court. I don't have anything to do with it. I wasn't privy to this whole thing. So if you're able to sort yourself out, fine. If not, fine. I'm okay with whatever decision you come up with. So she left. The next day, she called again that the guy has gone too far, that she cannot go back. She cannot put a stop to it, that they've spent money, they've printed cards, they've done this. So again, it's your decision to make. I don't have anything to say. Just do the needful and do whatever you want. So she left and she went ahead with the whole marriage plans. I attended the marriage. I went there with my friends, congratulated her, and she was very...
You think that was a good thing to do, attending the marriage? For me, I don't think I'll go. I'll not be able to take it.
No, I went because...
Guys, will you be able to, like, your ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend, and you guys broke up badly, will you be able to attend that kind of wedding? For me, I cannot go.
No, I just attended because then I was... way past. I just had to put everything there because of my law school. I didn't want to fail law school, so I had to look for a way to, and I attended because I didn't go. It would have been the news because I was very, very popular in school and a lot of people were very concerned, to the extent that even the indigents in the community, they were willing to even disrupt the marriage. But I said no, leave her, let her do her marriage and go. So,
but guys, have you guys had any of such experiences? Like, what's the worst breakup experience? Like, I don't know, I think it's the worst I've heard.
It's the worst actually, because the whole thing is so funny, you know. Even at the marriage, when she saw me at first in church, she was very uncomfortable.
Of course, so, it would be.
So they now made arrangement for bodyguards, bouncers.
Maybe
their
mind, they wanted to scatter
everything. Yeah, that was our thought, but I'm bigger than that. I can't stoop so low to do that. So the whole thing, the whole marriage came and everything went, and that was...
She's happily married now.
Yes,
you're happily
happily married.
I'm happily married now.
I thank God because God answered my prayer.
Yeah.
You know when things like that happen, you tend to feel as if it's a bad thing, but yeah, it's a blessing in disguise actually.
Yeah.
So that's my story.
It was quite... anyway, guys, what do you guys think about this whole thing? Have you had any experiences like this? What's the worst breakup experience? Let's chat in the comment section. Let's get interactive, guys. So let me know what you guys think. If it were you, would you attend the wedding? Would you attend that kind of wedding? Because me, Prudence at Pinoco, I would not attend that kind of wedding, number one. Number two, I don't think... Anyway, I don't know, but I don't think the girl was unaware. She was very, very much aware. She must have been double dating. You understand?
I think so too.
So, guys, so we have come to the end of this video. I'm expecting to see all your comments in the comment section, you know. And today is day 6 of our 7 days upload. I didn't miss any day. I've tried. So
thanks for watching.
Thank you so much for watching, guys. Subscribe if you have not subscribed. Hit the like button, drop a comment. Of course, I want to see all of you commenting in this video. And like, please, it always helps my channel. Please, I beg you.
Notification bell.
So whenever we post,
you get updates.
Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in our next one. Bye.
Bye, guys.